ending. From your shoulders down to your toes, relax your body. Really loosen, let me be calm. Arms so heavy, loose and limp, your body relaxes, loose and limp, your body feels so loose and limp. Excellent, very wonderful. To put you back under, I'll just look at you and say the words 3, 2, 1. The minute I do this, you're going to go right back under, even deeper. My friends, from now on, all the suggestions I give you will feel real and vivid. We're going to escape a little extra reality here today. Before the show really starts, though, I'm going to place what's called a post-hypnotic suggestion. And I use this suggestion every show because it's a great way to get their imaginations and their subconscious mind rolling and clicking. It's a sense of smell. Now, it's a very simple thing. I'm going to say a key word. Every time I say the word Orlando, every time I say the word Orlando, you're going to visualize the person next to you wearing the worst cologne fragrance smell ever. You're going to visualize the person next to you, they smell really, really bad. The only way that smell goes away is to stand up, change seats, get away from the person next to you, the smell goes away. It'll be the weirdest feeling. The memory of a really bad smell will come forward. You'll stand up, but it'll go away. Woo! How are you doing? How are you doing? Look how bella you are. Wow! Hi, how are you? Looks like you needed that sleep. Yes. How are you, sir? What's your name?
Memo.
Memo, you feel pretty relaxed?
Yeah.
So how are you?
Good.
You feel comfortable?
Really comfortable.
You were never asleep?
No.
Never unconscious?
No.
You heard everything going on, right? You knew where you were, right?
No. You don't care.
I don't care.
What's your name, sir?
Bob.
Nice to have you up here, Bob. I'm Ricky Kalmon. The most important thing is I overemphasize this a lot because this is about you guys. I want you to have some people from Orlando the other day. They were telling me how cold it was only just a couple weeks ago, but now it's the weather is getting a lot better. And so anyway, Bob, thanks for coming here from Connecticut. We appreciate it. And those of you that come from all parts of the world, and then where you live, you came together for this holiday together. Anyway, so regardless, whether it's Connecticut, Orlando, Atlanta, Chicago, it doesn't make a difference. Mexico, I talked to somebody from Argentina. It doesn't make a difference where you're from. We're celebrating together. We're having a big... Well, everybody stand up, change seats, it goes away. Stay there, it's going to get worse. Find a different chair, do whatever you're going to do. Find a better chair. Just switch the seats to somebody else. Find a better seat, do whatever you do. Bob, Connecticut over there. What's your name, sir?
Jordan.
Jordan. Better over here?
Yeah.
Where's it coming from?
Over there.
What's your name? Oh, no. It was good talking to you while we had the time. Jordan, where are you from?
Tampa.
Tampa, so that's not far from Orlando. How long of a drive is that?
An hour.
Do you go to Orlando a lot from Tampa?
No.
Well, you know, because you got the park. You can do whatever. Hi, Bob. Hello. You okay there, man?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was pretty bad smell, huh? Yeah, it's okay. You all right? Okay, I'm not tripping, I'm just a napkin. They're going to think and believe this napkin is a $100 bill. Every time I give them a napkin, they think it's $100. They're going to take it from me. And they're going to put it somewhere very safe and sound where nobody would ever guess to look. Hide your money. Don't take anybody else's. Get very real. I showed you this cool little thing you can do with your senses, right, Bob? All right, Bob and Victoria, all the way down, I'll go right in the middle. I gave you a little something cool to have fun with, but before I do, I want to make sure you're the happiest people on the ship right now. Look at this. Look. We're coming up here today. It took a lot of courage. Did I skip anybody? I skipped you. I'm so sorry. I can't write about you. Anybody else I forgot? I'm so sorry about this. Oh, Bob, dude. One, two, three. No, keep your hands to yourself. There we go. $400. You're a good guy from Connecticut. There we go. Other Bob over here. Jeremy, is it? Will. Hi, how are you? $100. Who's having the greatest time ever? Let me know right now if it's $100. Who's having the greatest time? Whoa, Victoria was the first hand up. Any random spontaneous expressions of fun gets $100? Yeah! All right, that's fine. Never, ever, ever been on the Disney Cruise Line before. First timers, there we go, good. All right. That's for you guys. guys. So you've been on before? That's all right. There we go. Good. That's it for you. This is for you. This is for you. This is for you. Let me ask you a question, Bob. I've given you all this cash. Are you going to keep it to yourself or share it to the ones you're with? Other Bob, keep it to yourself or share it with the ones you're with? Is anybody going to take the $100 I got? Oh, there we go. Good. All right. Put your money away. Keep it away. That's it. Safe and sound. Hide it quick. Keep your back against the chair so you're balanced. Look up to the ceiling for us, my friends. 3, 2, 1. You think you're Jack Sparrow, and you're going to stand up and fight the invisible pirates. No running, jumping, or leaping around. When I say the color blue, you're back to normal. You understand? Nod your head. When I say pirate, you think you're a pirate. No running, jumping, or leaping. You understand? Okay. Great. How would you describe your experience so far?
Amazing.
Hey, thank you very much. Victoria, come here for a second. Blue.
One room on the ship, but we don't have like 6,000 Sandy wipes. What's going on? All right.